The World AIDS Day, which falls on December the 1st, is dedicated to raising awareness of HIV/AIDS. People show their support for those infected with HIV/AIDS by donning a red ribbon on the day. In November 2012, then-Chinese Vice President Xi Jinping visited a group of HIV carriers, doctors, and anti-AIDS volunteers at a community clinic in South Beijing on the eve of World AIDS Day. She said HIV/AIDS is a common challenge for humanity. He said since the first AIDS patient was detected in China, the party and the government have attached great importance to anti-HIV/AIDS work and implemented effective measures with remarkable results. She said, "We must take note that the situation for preventing and controlling HIV/AIDS is still grave. Prejudice against HIV-affected people remains serious, and there is a lot to do in the field of HIV/AIDS prevention and control."
当时这个病人住进我们协和医院的ICU病房之后，病情急剧加重，出现了一型呼衰，这样做了气管、切开来支持呼吸，但是诊断仍然无法明确。这个时候呢，请王爱霞教授来会诊这个病人。王教授呢，根据他得到的国际上关于艾滋病的最新知识，高度怀疑这是一例艾滋病病人合并了卡氏。
Therefore, Wang Aixia took 5 milliliters of blood sample from the patient and separated 3 milliliters of serum sample, which was found strongly positive in HIV antibody testing. The patient's doctor in the US also confirmed that he was infected with HIV/AIDS. The human immunodeficiency virus, or HIV, targets the immune system and weakens people's defense against many infections and some types of cancer. There is no cure for HIV infection.
就觉得这种病就是一种不治之症，患上之后可能就是没有多久的寿命。Antiretroviral
therapy, which uses a combination of at least three antiretroviral drugs, does not cure HIV infection, but highly suppresses viral replication within a person's body and allows an individual's immune system to recover.
对于大多数已经接受正规治疗的患者来说, 艾滋病已经成为了一种可控的慢性疾病。
China has been vigorously fighting HIV/AIDS for years.
早发现是艾滋病防治的关键一步。从全球范围来看，中国已经建立起相对完善的艾滋病病毒检测网络。与此同时，不同类型的防艾公益组织也通过公众宣传、同伴教育。
In November 2013, in a written instruction on China's anti-HIV/AIDS work, President Xi Jinping stressed that the prevention and control of HIV/AIDS concerns people's life and health and social harmony and stability, and is the obligatory responsibility of the party and the government. During the 13th five-year period, China has made notable progress in HIV/AIDS prevention and treatment, with HIV transmission through blood transfusion basically eliminated, while mother-to-child transmission has reached an all-time low. More than 90% of AIDS patients have received medical attention, and the overall HIV/AIDS epidemic situation remains at a low level.
随着科学的进步，防治体系的强大，相信。
终结艾滋的愿景一定能够实现，让我们携起手来传递爱，共建美好的家园。